Good afternoon and welcome to Westminster Church in what is to be, in normal times, the annual memorial organ recital. But at last we're back up and about again for the most part. So thank you for being here. And we are most grateful to the many individuals and families who have made this program possible. It is indeed a great honor to present Carol Williams in concert. She is widely acknowledged as one of the finest organists of our day. Dr. Williams has been praised by the media as a gifted, dazzling, and eloquent. She established an international reputation for her artistry with performances in celebrated venues throughout the globe. In the narthex, you will find a wide variety of Dr. Williams's CDs, as well as scores of her own arrangements and original compositions. These items will be available for purchase at the intermission and after the concert. Dr. Williams welcomes the opportunity to greet you in the narthex following the program. And now will you join me in welcoming Dr. Carol Williams.
Can you hear the organ? It is fantastic to be here. The last concert I did away was March the 9th on 2020, and this is the first one after everything that we have been through. It really is amazing to be back on the road. I can assure you that I have played the organ since then. That was a piece by Louis Couperin, the Chaconne, and now a piece by the great German-English composer George Frederick Handel. What a composer it was. Can you hear me seriously okay the way I speak? Because I can't make head or tail of what you look like with these things on. The arrival of the Queen of Sheba. It would make a very good wedding piece, wouldn't it? Thank you very much. I'm going to move on to two pieces but now. The first one is by Johann Sebastian Bach. It's the beautiful Siciliana, which is arranged for organ, and it highlights some incredible flutes on this organ. This is truly a magnificent instrument, and it's just such fun to play. I really had a great time rehearsing here. The Siciliana by Bach. And then Psalm 19 by Marcello. We got two distinct instruments here, which is how they had instruments in Italy, in Venice, in many Italian big churches. They had often two instruments and two balconies, two choirs. Kind of greedy, really, isn't it? But, you know, so I'm going to use part of the instrument here, which you'll hear clearly, and then for the little organ, I'm going to use the instrument right back there. And there's somebody sitting up there, and I hope you're okay, because it's... Don't get too close to the instrument. We don't know much about Marcello. All we know is he wrote the piece before he died. It's a very small button, all right? I can play the organ, but anything technical. So that is a weird feeling for an organist to play here and then to have the echo back there. And it takes me back to when I was had a couple of recitals at St. Paul's Cathedral in London, that huge, huge instrument where you have the chancel organ, a bit like this, two cases. They go back to 1652, if I'm right. And then you have an organ in the dome, which is a bit like that instrument there, which you cannot really hear. And then at the back of the cathedral, where all the lovely little postcards are and the gifts and all those little knickknacks, you have the enchemard trumpets, which are big vertical trumpets, and you are not allowed to use those trumpets when the gift shop's open. Obvious reasons. So how many of you like piano music? Oh, it's a shame, isn't it? I'm playing the organ. But I've put in something just for you. I think you prefer that the bath, don't you? Probably not the ideal piece for a Sunday morning, but it is fun. It is fun. The next piece of music you'll probably recognize, and if you don't recognize it now, you'll recognize it next time you hear it. Beethoven, Beethoven's Seventh Symphony, not the whole symphony, the beautiful Allegretto, or really Adagio, which is one of the most poignant tearjerkers of pieces of music that I know. It was used in the movie, the 2010 movie, The King's Speech. Some of you might know that movie. If you don't know the movie, I honestly recommend watching it. It's with Colin Firth. It's about King George VI getting over his major stutter in life to give a very, very important speech about World War II. The music was slipped in behind this, and it just works so amazingly. I've done it with an actor, and it's a very, very, as I said, poignant moment. So I'm just going to not have anybody read the speech now, but just we're going to concentrate on the music. We're going to be using the strings from all the instruments, all the keyboards, bringing them together, all the luscious, delicious sounds that this instrument produces. No foundation sounds from the organ. Everything is a string or a very light reed with tremolants. Oh, very naughty, I know, but let's use those tremolants and have some fun. So the slow movement, I've heard this played at so many different speeds, but in the end, the instrument will tell me the speed to play, so I'm going to listen to her. Slow movement from Beethoven's Seventh Symphony.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, it's getting warm, isn't it? One more piece to take us up to intermission. I've got a new CD out there, Rejoice, and it's got a lot of the music that I'm playing this afternoon on it. So if you like the music, there you go. If you don't, well, don't bother, right? I mean, it's up to you. This next piece by Max Reger, his Introduction and Passacaglia in D minor. It is one of the most powerful pieces of organ music, and the opening is so strong, it's incredibly loud. Reger had a really strong temper, and he would often file things in the waste paper bin. And then he had said that if it was important, that they would write to him again. You can get that in his music. He's really, really got a bit of anger in the opening. But then you get into the Passacaglia, where you have the theme, which is stated very clearly. You'll hear it quiet in the pedals. That keeps repeating all the way through the Passacaglia, and then you have variations building up above this, and the instrument gets louder and louder, and we end with the introduction that we had at the beginning. So we're going to have the Introduction of Passacaglia in D minor, a little quick break, and then I'll see you all, hopefully, for the second half. Thank you. That can only be George Frederick Handel. Man, that man could really write good music. He was such an interesting gentleman. I love the history of music. He was a millionaire many times, became extremely poor, became very wealthy, up and down. He wrote hits, you know, contemporary of Johann Sebastian Bach, and very, very different people indeed. The next piece of music I have slipped in. I have so much music at home. People always give me music. They think I don't have much music, you know. Oh, I'm sure you'd like this, three boxes of music, you know. But somebody did give me some music recently, and I beavered my way through it and found this, what I would call a souffle of music. It's by the composer Petro Young. No, it's not by Petro Young, I got that wrong. It's by the composer Lanny Smith. Not Lonnie Smith, Lanny Smith. And it's called Arabesque for Flutes. And it's just, as I say, a little souffle, a little bit of Thank you very much. I do love to compose music, and I have written a symphony for organ. I am not going to play the whole symphony. I'm just going to do three of the movements. The first movement, which I am not playing, actually states the themes, but the themes are very clear, actually. You'll hear them in the movement I'm going to play first, the movement that takes us back to Baroque times, and you'll hear a tiny little fuga with one of the themes, and then a little fluffy section again, which reminds me of the music of Nikolaus Bruns and so forth. And then the third movement takes similar themes, but I treat it in the Romantic period, the French Romantic period, and I looked for and found the harmonic flutes on the organ. So you have that lovely, beautiful harmonic flute. So if you're in a huge cathedral, and it's just a lovely effect. And then the third movement is à la moderne. I had my first attempt, actually, and I really enjoyed it, at writing a tone row. Some of you who are musicians will know what I'm talking about. If you don't, well, don't worry about it. It's not very important. But anyway, you'll hear a very strange melody, and that's definitely what a tone row is, based on the fugue subject that you heard in the Baroque part. Well, if you didn't get any of that, don't worry about it. Three movements. That's it.
Thank you.
is a great piece, isn't it? The Waltz of the Flowers. I was using the Zimbelsterns up there for that, and it just added something. Oh, you should feel like dancing with music like that. Bit hard for me, but I enjoyed that. Thank you. A piece of music that's not in print yet by yours truly. It's just a sketch. Really, most of it's in my head. I played this for the organ of Notre Dame in Paris. It's an homage to Vierne, homage à Vierne, one of the greatest French organists who's ever lived. One of my icons. I just love his music. He was organist at Notre Dame Cathedral for 37 years. It's incredible, isn't it? 37 years. And he died playing a concert. I'm not going to dwell on that tonight, this afternoon. But I've taken the theme from the Third Symphony. I played the whole Third Symphony of his there. And some of you, if you know your Vierne, might recognize the theme from the Third Symphony. Homage to Vierne by yours truly.
Thank you.
Thank you. That's a good piece to let off steam to, you know, get rid of that energy. Got to say that the American Guild of Organists are here this afternoon, so I think they'll have some information at the back. If you are an organist, a budding organist, or if you know somebody who is an organist and would like information about the Guild, they do fantastic work for the whole of the organ world. So take a leaflet at the back if you're so interested. I do have scores here this afternoon, and my husband's here, Kerry's here, and a dear friend of ours, Craig, and our beloved Dietrich Buxtehude Bell. He's the canine of the family, and he's the dog out there with the service jacket on. He usually has a tuxedo, but I forgot the tuxedo, so he's there. He's a great dog, so he really does appreciate any sales. You know, when they say, I'm just thinking, when they say new and tastier dog food, who tastes that stuff? Oh, this is what I'm going to play. A cantabile, and then Jubilate Deo, which is based on the famous Jubilate Deo theme, which you will hear so clearly because I'm using the great big tuba from the solo division. So Jubilate Deo, but first a cantabile.
Thank you.
I'd like to thank John Neely, who invited me to play here. Wonderful gentleman. You are very, very lucky to have this gentleman here as your director of music. I'd also like to thank Jason for turning my pages this afternoon for the Max Reger. I'd like to thank also Matt and the whole of the organ team for getting this instrument, well, to keeping her in tip-top condition. Will you give them all a round of applause, please? Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, terrific. You have been the best audience I've had in 2021. I will play you one more piece. And this is a piece of music that is not recommended for a postlude on a Sunday morning, unless you want a new job. I will see you at the back with the CDs and DVDs, and I hope I can say hello to every one of you. We probably won't shake hands. I think they've all just told us not to do anything like that now, but we'll smile it. I can't see you smile. I can see you smile in your eyes, but I look forward to meeting you at the end of the performance. You take care of yourselves, keep well, and God bless. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. I've had enough. One more, and then I want to see you at the back. One more. A piece of music, again, I stumbled on, and it's a great piece. See you at the back after this.